There's a recipe in James about how to defeat the enemy, and I like saying it. It's kind of like a God sandwich. It says, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Draw near to God, and he will draw near to you.
Amen.
So, first, submit to God, resist the devil, he'll flee from you, and then draw near to God, and he'll draw near to you. Notice that it's sandwiched by closeness and nearness and submitting and intimacy with God. And that in the middle of that sandwich, you're resisting the devil. So it's going to be really hard for you to resist the devil if you're not submitting to God and you're not drawing near to God. You see that? So we need to step into the place of submitting to God and drawing near to God. And in that, it empowers us to resist the devil. And so we can tell the devil, if you don't know what scripture to say, you can just rebuke the devil. You say, I resist you in the name of Jesus, and you have to flee from me. You have to get away from me. You have to get off of me. So go now in the name of Jesus. That's what resisting the devil looks like.
Yeah.
It's not about willpower of, I have to stand and run. No, this is the power of God inside of you. That's submitting to God and drawing near to him will give you the empowerment to resist the devil. And that's the lies that he's telling you, the fear that he's making you feel, the pain that he wants to impact in you, the emotional stress and anxiety and trauma and feeling overwhelmed. And I just declare, Lord, that greater are you who's in us. I'm telling you, this scripture needs to be honest today. The Lord keeps bringing it to me. Greater is he who's in me. Let's say that. Greater is he who's in me than he that's in the world.
We will not be shaken. No, we will not be shaken. For we trust.
we're all going to look a little silly this morning, but it doesn't matter because we're not here to impress each other. All right? All right. So get your helmet of salvation in your hands. So Father, this morning, let's say this together. Father, this morning,
I put on the helmet of salvation
to guard my mind today.
Guard
what I think.
Guard what I hear.
Guard what I see.
Guard what I speak.
And I subject every thought.
To the blood of Jesus.
Help me to take every thought captive.
To the obedience of Christ.
Today I give no place.
To
the enemy in my mind. Breastplate. It's kind of wide and big because it covers a lot. There we go. Here we go. Let's put it on. I put on the breastplate of righteousness. To guard my heart. My will.
And
my emotions.
It is not my righteousness.
But the righteousness of Christ.
On the cross.
Today I will be righteous.
By the blood of Jesus.
Father, protect me.
From reacting to circumstances.
And people.
In an
emotional
way.
Let me respond. With my spirit.
Not out of my emotions.
All right. Good job. Now, let's get the belt of truth. Okay, now the belt holds all this thing together. So this is as we teach a triumph over trauma, this is not a fashion belt with sequins on it. This is a big weightlifter's belt, okay, that holds everything in. And now the belt is what everything, all of the rest of your armor attaches to this belt of truth. So let's put on our belt of truth. Father, I gird my loins. Your loins are important. All right. Jesus, you are the truth. And Satan, you're a liar. Today I choose to believe. The truth. Overcome feelings of overwhelmed and I'm not doing a good enough job or it's not happening in a timely fashion. So here's what the Lord told me to do. He said, I want you to write down everything on the bottom of your shoe. I want you to write down everything on the bottom of your shoe that feels overwhelming and that needs to get done. And it's trying to steal your peace. And it's trying to. So I did that on both my shoes this morning. And it's 5 a.m. And so I get to tread on the enemy's lies about not getting stuff done. So this is what we do to attack the enemy. We attack him with peace. We get real calm. We get real chill. And we're unshakable in this place. So you need to get your shoes on. Yeah. Okay, put on your shoes. Okay, now you need to know these aren't just But they do have, you know, Dr. Scholl's insoles in them. So they're really, really nice and squishy. You know, memory foam. But on the bottom, they've got spikes in them. And what the Roman soldiers would do is they would plant their feet in the spikes in the ground so that they could stand firm against the enemy. And they were immovable. There was no turning around and backing up and going the other way. They would stand their ground with their shield of faith in front of them, and they would press against the enemy. And so that's what you're doing with your peace today. So here we go. I put on my shoes of peace.
I put on my shoes of peace.
And today, wherever my feet take me, I will share the good news of Jesus.
I will share the good news of Jesus.
I will use my life.
I will use my life
to be an expression.
To be an expression
of your deep inner peace.
Of your deep inner peace.
The word says.
The word says.
Beautiful are the feet.
Beautiful are the feet
of those who bring good news.
Of those who bring good news.
Today I will bring good news.
Today I will bring good news
of Jesus.
Jesus.
And the power of Holy Spirit.
And the power of Holy Spirit.
And what was accomplished on the cross.
And what was accomplished on the cross.
And I will bring it to a hurting world.
And I will bring it to a hurting world.
See, people all around, they don't know what it looks like to have peace. And so when you walk with peace and you walk with confident hope and you walk in this space of I'm unshakable and I am treading on top of the enemy's lies. I'm walking on top of, and I'm not overwhelmed because overwhelmed is under my feet. And I'm not fearful because fearful is under my feet. And when we do that, people will recognize and they're like, man, I've had people come up to me and say, man, so joyful, like why are you so happy all the time, or why do you have peace, or why do you have, it's because I've been training myself to battle and roar against my enemy, the adversity, the devil. Right, so now we've got the body armor on fully, and so now we need to get some of our tools, our weapons. Okay, so here we go. So the first thing is our shield of faith. And so I learned some new things about the shield of faith. I always thought the shield, yes, they are big and tall. They were taller and wider than the warrior because they hid behind it when flaming arrows and things would come. But here's what I didn't know. I didn't know that it wasn't made out of metal. Their shields were actually, they were treated so the outside of them were actually hardwood. And then the middle part was usually about 6 layers of like leather and heavy material, and they would anoint their shields with oil to keep the leather conditioned and pliable. And then when they were going into battle and they knew that they were going to be attacked with fiery darts, they would soak their shield in water so that it would extinguish the fiery darts. I didn't know that about. Sorry, my guitar's. So, anyways, I learned this last week about the shield of faith and how much we need in our faith. We need the anointing of Holy Spirit in our faith. Okay? So that our faith, our shield is anointed by the power of Holy Spirit to extinguish every fiery dart, which are the lies of the enemy. Okay? So take up your shield. Yeah, and it's on their arm. So Father,
today,
I take up the shield of faith.
Which will, according to your word,
quench the fiery darts.
Quench the fiery darts
of the enemy.
Of the enemy.
The shield will not only stop the fiery darts.
The shield will not only stop the fiery darts.
And flaming arrows.
And flaming arrows.
But as I choose to stay behind the shield.
As I choose to stay behind the shield.
In humility.
In humility.
I will be protected.
I will be protected.
From every assault. That comes against me. Today I declare with my mouth.
Today I declare with my mouth.
That you, O Lord.
That you, O Lord.
Are the only true.
Are the only true.
And living God.
And living God.
And my faith.
My faith.
Is in you.
Is in you.
And you alone.
And you alone.
All right. Here we go. Get out your sword.
Yeah.
So this is a double-edged sword. And the sword is the word of God. Say, my sword.
My sword.
Is the word of God.
Is the word of God.
Now, the Bible tells us that our sword is double-edged. And the word that it talks about there, when it says the sword is the word of God, the word is rhema.
Right.
Say, rhema.
Rhema.
Now, that's a word that means God's spoken word to you.
Yes.
Okay? So that could be like when you open up the Bible and you read something and you feel in your spirit like, whoa, God just talked to me.
Yes.
Okay? You open up your Bible and it's like, oh my goodness, that I've read that probably 100 times, but this is like fresh and new for me today, and God is speaking to me. And it's also from God's mouth to your ears.
Yeah.
So this is where in our prayer time we're listening as much or more than we're talking. And we're letting God speak to us. I love what Lynn teaches in her class, that God is speaking all the time.
Yeah.
Are you listening?
Yes.
Are you listening? Because he's speaking over you all the time.
Yeah.
All the time. And he doesn't ever sleep, and he doesn't ever slumber. So apparently he's got a lot to say over you and over me, and so we need to be listening. So this sword is double-edged. So one side is God speaking to you. The other side is you speaking the truth. You speaking the very word that God gave you. That's the double-edged sword. So here we go. Let's take up our sword.
Today,
I take up the sword of the Spirit.
I take up the sword of the Spirit.
Which is the rhema of God.
Which is the rhema of God.
It is alive and active.
It is alive and active.
And sharper than a two-edged sword.
And sharper than a two-edged sword.
Which cuts in both directions. And your word, Lord, says.
And your word, Lord, says.
That life and death.
That life and death.
Are in the power of my tongue.
Are in the power of my tongue.
So today I choose life.
Today I choose life.
I will use my words.
I will use my words.
With caution.
With caution.
And self-control.
And self-control.
So as not to harm anyone.
So as not to harm anyone.
But to destroy Satan.
But to destroy Satan.
And his strongholds and schemes. Lord,
Lord,
put a guard upon my lips.
Put a guard upon my lips.
That I may not sin against you.
That I may not sin against you.
Or others. With my mouth.
With my mouth.
I thank you for the sword of the Spirit.
I thank you for the sword of the Spirit.
Which is another one of my offensive weapons.
Which is another one of my offensive weapons.
Use me today, Lord.
Use me today, Lord.
To effectively tear down.
To effectively tear down.
Strongholds.
Amen.
Okay, now there's another part here that a lot of people miss out on.
Yeah.
It says, once you get that arm on, it says, pray in the Spirit at all times.
Yeah.
Okay? Pray in the Spirit at all times. So, here's what we're going to do. We've got our arm on, we've got our shield, and we've got our sword, but now we need to connect with Holy Spirit and pray what He's praying. And speak what He's speaking. And believe what He's wanting us to believe. Okay? So here we go. Lord, I thank you for giving me the full armor.
I thank you for giving me the full armor.
Which will protect me today. As I put on the armor. I seal this act.
I seal this act.
In the blood of Jesus.
In the blood of Jesus.
And I place a hedge of protection.
And I place a hedge of protection.
Around myself.
Around myself.
And my family.
And my family.
I reverse any curses.
I reverse any curses.
Or judgments.
Or judgments.
Which have been spoken against me.
Which have been spoken against me.
And I send them back to Satan.
I send them back to Satan.
Who tried to send them to me in the first place.
Who tried to send them to me in the first place.
I ask today. That you would dispatch.
That you would dispatch.
Warring angels.
Warring angels.
And ministering angels.
My guardian angels,
to establish around me, and to guard and protect me,
so that I can accomplish
all that you've asked me to do today.
You have asked me to do
privilege to love and serve you. I declare with my mouth that there is no one like you. I love you with all my heart.
I love you with all my heart.
With all my soul.
With all my soul.
With all my mind.
With all my mind.
With all my strength.
With all my strength.
You are a good, good Father.
You are a good, good Father.
May my life
be pleasing to you
today.
I worship you
in spirit and in truth.
Hallelujah.
Well done, guys.
Jesus.
I live in the shelter of the Most High.
I live in the shelter of the Most High.
I find rest in the shadow of the Almighty.
I find rest in the shadow of the Almighty.
The Lord alone is my refuge.
The Lord alone is my refuge.
My place of safety.
My place of safety.
He is my God.
He is my God.
And I trust in Him.
And I trust in Him.
For He rescues me from every trap.
He rescues me from every trap.
And protects me from deadly disease.
And protects me from deadly disease.
His faithful promises.
His faithful promises.
Are my armor and my protection.
Are my armor and my protection.
Because I make the Lord my refuge.
Because I make the Lord my refuge.
I make the Most High my shelter.
And I make the Most High my shelter.
No evil.
No evil.
No evil.
No evil.
Will conquer me.
Will conquer me.
And no disease.
And no disease.
Or plague will come near my home.
Or plague will come near my home.
For He orders His angels.
For He orders His angels.
To protect me.
To protect me.
Wherever I go.
Wherever I go.
The Lord rescues me because I love Him.
The Lord rescues me because I love Him.
He protects me because I trust in His name.
He protects me because I trust in His name.
When I call on Him, He answers.
When I call on Him, He answers.
He is with me in times of trouble.
He is with me in times of trouble.
He rescues and honors me.
He rescues and honors me.
He rewards me with long life and salvation.
He rewards me with long life and salvation.
Psalm 91.
Amen. Psalm 91.
Fighting for us, fighting for us. You can have a fragile heart. And what happens when you have a fragile heart is that it's easily broken. It's easily shattered. It's easily disappointed. The enemy takes advantage of a fragile heart. Children, little children have fragile hearts. They're brand new, okay? We have fragile hearts throughout our lifetime, and people come in and betray us. They speak bad about us. They don't treat us the way we need to be treated or deserve to be treated. Okay, they're not there for us when we need them. Jesus is the strength of your heart. You have to strengthen your heart in the love of God. What we've been singing is, the reason that we're not shaken is because of His unfailing love. You got someone. You got a higher power. You got the God of the universe, the creator of the universe, adoring you. He created you, and He is so proud of you. He's not mad at you. He's not irritated with you. He's not disappointed in you. He's adoring you. He loves you. He's on your side. He's cheering for you. He's like, yeah, that's good. Good. Do it again. Do it again. Practice that again. That's awesome. And He looks to the angels and He goes, don't you just look like me? You look just like me. Like father, like son, right? So, your heart is a muscle. It's got to be strengthened. The song we just sang is that you're the strength of my heart. What strengthens our heart is knowing that we know that we know that we know that we know that we're loved. We're completely, unconditionally loved. And what that does is it frees us up to love other people. Because when you're loved, there isn't anything that stops you from being able to communicate it to somebody else. It's when we don't feel loved, they're like, man, I don't got nothing to give you. Because I don't got nothing, right? But your love is what strengthens us. Your love is what keeps us from shaking. Your love is what fills us up.
And if you love, they feel it.
Amen.
They know
Amen.
You love them.
Yeah.
I worked for Nate for many years. I can't tell you the number of experiences I had just because I loved on some people. Honestly, I'm in Oakland, California, and I got a 6'6" black lady walking into my car at 10:30 at night, and she's like, it's awesome. And they love it. If you love them, they'll love on you.
Look behind you. try to, which is get out on the wheel, and you're holding on to the strut, ready, set, go. I can remember everything you're lifting. Just like, oh, I don't want to let go, and boom, gone. You know what I mean? And he said, he wants us to let go, but he's not going to tell us what he got for us. He's just not going to do it. That's what the faith goes in. There's the, you know, he's really impressive by me. We've got to let go. Whether it's mother, brother, sister, drugs, I mean, whatever it is, it's wholeness. It's wholeness from moving on to here. We've got to just let go of it.
Stronger than mine.
Jesus, we thank you. Amen. Let's have a great day.
Victoria and Leslie.